Yeah,
hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome to the Hangover Podcast with me, Shovon Malcolm. Enjoy.
Girls from fantasies that do things, put them on the line like kings from Southern Africa. I'm getting tax paid to me unofficially. Rappers is officially done, they're getting clarity. They're playing checkers with me, I'm playing chess. B feeling like I'm half from checkmates. Yeah, we back. We here. We out. We getting ground up. We back. We here. We out. We getting ground up. We back, we here, we out, we getting crowned up. We back, yeah, we here, we out, we getting crowned up.
The rule is here, you will never measure up in this cool since preschool. Go ahead and press your luck, you are not on my par. This rap shit got rap acts who got skills like Bad Black. Out of jail, nigga, no bars. And it's quite depressing, so I look into the mirror just to see progression. This here's the king's speech, your peasants need a lesson. I write you a life sentence, cause my words are weapons. I got with a couple of dope models, a couple of broads who like to co-role models, a couple of actresses who like to play roles like dope models, after having a couple of coke bottles. So yes, accept I am royal. Tight flow like it was struck in the corridor. Kabakawa rap, this is what I'm here for. I'm bringing in the new air, semi-kokiro. Yeah,
we back,
we speaking,
we here,
we speaking,
we out, we getting crowned up. We back,
we speaking,
we here,
we
out, we getting crowned up. We back,
we speaking,
we here, we out, we getting crowned up. We back,
we speaking,
we here, we out, we getting crowned up. We back,
we speaking,
we here, we out.
That is Three Kings coming in.
Yep,
LB.
Lyrical proof
and the man,
the myth
and the man,
Enygma.
I don't want to do it.
Just chill, you can't handle production by the legendary Cause and Effect.
Okay,
yeah, crazy tune. This, he gave us this beat several months ago, actually, sometime last year. The moment he got in our inboxes, all of us were like, oh my god, we are so dead. Like, this beat is insane. And this was the follow up to the track Clarity Anthem, you remember?
Yeah, I remember that one
last year.
Yeah,
and if you all remember, on her. On the hook, she says something about we be killing them on Valentine's Day. Yeah, so we deliberately released this track on Valentine's Day.
Whoa.
Just to show people that we have our consistency. And this is going to be off the Moment of Clarity EP that we're releasing as the three of us as a group.
Okay.
Miracle Proof of the Myth and Benny Black as well.
Uh-huh.
It's going to have about, I think, 9 tracks.
Wow.
Yes.
Well, we'll be waiting for that one. But the Clarity song was off the hook. I respected you for that.
Thank
you know, your bars always coming in a weird way. At times I'm like, will I ever be an MC or something like that? Because really, you find yourself, you listen to Enygma and you're like, well, how is he doing it? There's some guys that I always listen to, I'm like, okay, wow. But all happens, all goes down. All goes down. And even Clary, the Three Kings coming through on this one. That was also another exceptional song that you happened to do.
Yes.
Now that one. But well, 24 minutes past the hour of 12 o'clock, and you're still right here on the hang with me, the King, Shovon Malcolm, getting on till the hour of 2 o'clock with me and Enygma. Do that thing. Do that thing.
Let me keep it for now. I'll bring it out later.
But well, last Saturday some stuff went down, and certain people were like, probably they missed it out, they wanted to hear it again. And well, it's so good that I have the main man, the lyricist, in the building, who's gonna let us know what he thinks about all this stuff.
Okay.
Yeah. Meek Mill and Wiz Khalifa.
Uh-huh. What happened with
these
Meek Mill?
These two homeboys decided to go for a freestyle.
Uh-huh.
And they did it in their way.
Uh-huh.
And probably if you missed out that day, all that time, this is the way it's going to go
now. But Wiz Khalifa is going to get bodied.
Yo, you think so?
Let me hear.
Well, this is Wiz Khalifa coming in first on his verse, Enygma. Listen out to this one real cool.
I'm going to just rap, though. Be like,
Rolling up the grass, living better than them niggas that I used to look up to. I could show you how to come up. Yeah, I came up from the gutter to a condo out in Hollywood, where the weather's good and the party's always popping up on somebody and dropping off some tree. That mean I got enough to go around. Everything's for the free, so you ain't gotta smoke with my homies. Down to go to any one town and get this paper. I swear ain't nobody do me no favors. Twisting up the medicine, shitting on my competition. Easy parts forgetting, but the hardest parts to try forgiving. Niggas for mistaking me or thinking I was the one to wait. Thought that I was younger, I was dumb. But much of having energy. Now look at my wife, she got a pornographic figure. And my autograph is bigger to your nieces and your nephews than yours ever was. Not to mention your niggas. You caught them repping Taylor Gang with us. TMZ cameras, paparazzi taking pictures. I spark up a J and ask them if you wanna take one with us. Made man, ain't nobody make a nigga. I'm about to book a flight to Vegas, trying to take one with us. You niggas too small, dog. Me, I'm thinking bigger. Critics comment on how I'm smoking weed and drinking liquor, on how I was nominated but not the winner. But you should start counting up how much I made this year.
That is first, the first part.
Nice, nice, nice.
Wiz Khalifa coming in. But now, your judgment is going to come in after
and
this.
After the, yeah, let me listen to what Meek Mill did and then I'll listen.
Okay.
Yeah, one thing's for sure, two things for certain. Got booked with three bricks, you back home, niggas working. Clown that niggas should've put you in the circus. Home of Philly, if you get a Benz, niggas lurking. Churches, hearses, is it really worth it? If you heard he telling, why you dapping and conversing? Lock me in a cell, let me strap up my converses. Before I drop a dime, tell them people a line. Swear to God, man, I was 19, I caught my first case. Nine co-defendants and snitching wasn't the worst case. Had a hard time giving my name and my birthday. But nowadays, niggas go to jail and it's an earthquake. They get all shook up, write a whole book up. Ratting they connect out, tell them where they got the hook up. Got a nigga 20 years talking about that cook up. Back to the home, niggas fucking with him, good luck. 12 shots of Henny to the face, got me stood up. Any situation, ask about me, I stood up. Catch you slipping like a transmission. Your hood up, from my hood to your hood. Good, what up? Nothing though, my hood high. Smack and leave a nigga look like SpongeBob. I couldn't get it, hold up. Yeah, I say, all I know is flex. Shitting on my ex, bad hoes on my team. Dicking down like necks, I rock, YSL so fresh. Fly as hell, no jet. Waves on them 3-6, make that piece get so wet. She say I'm cocky, I say that's not me. She call me Poppy, and I say Vinaki. Wrist wear on hockey, push box like Ali. My sneaks, they Bali, in my hood, I'm proudly. Just roll around in that goat, watching out for them folks. Heater on my hip, trunk full of that work. I say, my shooters like dirt, 10 racks and you murk. Dirt. I put that on your head, first week and you dead. I bottle pop, I model pop. Kick me on them bikes, let the bottle pop. Niggas know I'm nice, and I got a lot. Like F your corner, I buy the block. It's Maybach,
Maybach.
We way back.
Way back.
Yeah, I was starving, this the payback. It's off the top. But I say,
nice.
I got my hustle from Hova and my stuntin' from Baby. That's why I'm ucking them over. And my new watch cost me 80. Woo. Got a couple of Rovers, had to drop my Mercedes. I know these suckers don't like me. I'm probably popping they lady. I got 100 racks on me now. No computer, but I got a Mac on me now. And I'm a shooter, I really clap, homie, now. And fuck the jail, cause my nigga Ross hold me down. I'm getting bail when we in the fresh out the dealership. I just came in the game, but I'm killing shit. I'm nigga wild.
Yeah. Well, coming in from Meek Mill.
Uh-huh.
And Wiz Khalifa. Yep. Well, you want to hear what Enygma has to say about this? Stay tucked and stay listening. You're on the Hangover with the King.
Yo, this is Enygma. Shovon isn't playing around. Game over. He's going to take over. Stay tuned to the Hangover.
Well, indeed, I'm taking over right now. It is all my hood. It is all my city. Well, interesting stuff. But, well, before we went to the break, we came through Wiz Khalifa
versus
Meek
Mill.
So many people out there were thinking, you know, they have their own things. You know, everybody was like, maybe Meek Mill, Wiz Khalifa, and all that. But I want to hear from the lyricist. You have these guys knocked down, hit the points on straight. And I got nothing to say about that. You know, tell me what
to say. There are very many
say.
Things that we take into consideration when we're judging verses. You have to look at, you know, definitely lyricism.
Yep.
You know, how adept is he at writing.
Mm-hmm.
You have to look at the flow someone employs.
Yeah.
You have to look at some of the wordplay that they include in there. You have to look at some of the technical aspects like multi-syllabic rhyming, in rhymes, alliteration, metaphors. So you combine all these elements to judge a body of work and say that this verse or this track is dope. So right now, it seems like they're both asked to give a freestyle off the top of their head, probably, on radio.
Yeah.
And both of them did a decent job. They were given interesting beats, and both of them killed it. However, I would note that Wiz Khalifa was the only one who was spitting off the top of his head from beginning to end.
Mm-hmm.
He jumped on that beat, and everything he said, he thought of on spot, off the top of the head, most of it.
Mm-hmm.
With Meek Mill, he was giving a written for the first probably 16 bars.
Okay.
He was spitting just written stuff that he has in the verse somewhere else, maybe on his album, I don't know. Then after he had finished his written, he switched into freestyle mode. And after that, his verse started dying. The quality of his verse went down, started becoming, he was spitting a lot of whack Rick Ross style stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And he did that for a while, did freestyle for a while. Then I think he also noticed that the quality of what he's spitting now is garbage. So he went back into written again at around the time when he starts talking about Jehovah and everything. There he was going back into written again, and his quality came up towards the end.
Okay,
but well, that lull of the gap where he was freestyling and it was nonsense, I think we'll end up taking the victory away from Meek Mill, and I give it to Wiz Khalifa, because even though it wasn't so dope lyrically, he was at least consistent throughout with what he was doing. There weren't really so many punchlines or anything. My favorite line in his verse was where he talked about how his girlfriend has a pornographic figure, and now my order graph is bigger. that was really
some dope stuff.
Was some good multi-syllabic rhyme scheme there. And again, he freestyled throughout. His flow was ridiculous. Like, his flow on that beat was insane. Yeah, so I'll give it to Wiz Khalifa. I never thought this day would happen.
That's what I thought of at first. I was like, well, Meek Mill sounded so interesting. Yeah, yes. It was there. But I think Wiz Khalifa did a better job. Because I was actually watching the video, and I was like, whoa, Wiz Khalifa was getting his stuff. That's why, in some way, somehow, Wiz Khalifa like lost out the words and like he swallowed them up, and then he came back again. It recuperated. But well, even that was a Meek Mill. Actually wasn't getting off somewhere. I don't know, maybe I crammed it or something.
I'm not saying that he was reading off his Blackberry or anything like Drake does.
Okay.
You know, guys will have writtens and they'll store them in their heads.
Yeah.
And then he spits it out because he's now under pressure. Maybe he was trying to compete with Wiz Khalifa. I don't know.
Yeah.
But, you know, and it's okay. It's allowed. There's nothing wrong with it.
Yeah, I know.
It's fine. But just that you could see the disparity that after he had finished with his written and he switched to freestyle, the quality went down big time. And that affected the overall opinion of his verse.
Yeah.
You know, if he had kept consistent, if he just stayed with the written throughout, then I would have probably given it to Meek Mill because he had so much wordplay, had so many punchlines. He had a very, very, very clever verse.
Yeah, I understand.
But it was there at the beginning, then it dipped down and he's now spitting garbage for a while, so that takes points away.
Uh-huh.
Then towards the end, he came up with one or two decent lines, but overall, Wiz Khalifa stayed consistent throughout. From beginning to end, kept it, you know, solid. And that's despite Meek Mill having a longer verse.
Okay. Well, and we have some messages coming up from different people on this one. This is Grace, who says, tell him that's what's up. And we have Fahad, who says, man, that's good. Yeah, welcome. We salute ya. And Jackson comes in and is like, hello, Enygma and Shovon, what's up? Thanks for the show. Shout out to all my Facebook friends. A big ups to Enygma for the good music. Kamo says, girls are his PowerPoint. What the hell is that? Explain. Get into details. What does he mean? The girls are your PowerPoint?
He's talking about corporate flow.
Oh.
You know corporate flow. Let me start. The opening bars are like, in my 3-piece suit, I'm a boss like Hugo. My black belt's cute, but I don't do judo. You know, I use worker's house as a shower joint after presentations of girls and my PowerPoint.
Oh, nice. Swag on 100,000 trillion.
That's what
I'll say. And Albert says, that dude is charismatic. Just that.
Thank you.
And Claire comes in to say, Corporate Flow, Three Kings, your new track with Mackenzie and JT are dope. And we have in Martin, who says, that one is a big guy, and we appreciate him. And we have more coming in from this one. This is
Wait, did he say big guy or big eye?
Big guy.
Okay. There's a rapper called Big Eye, and I would be offended if I was compared to
and,
his love.
Well, Imran says that UG's AMI, boy, you ill. What'd you say about that?
I actually used to hate MI.
But now?
But after he killed it on the BET Cypher. I respected what he did there. Mode 9 had the best verse on the BET Cypher.
Yeah, yeah.
But I think MI had the second best verse.
Okay.
So after that, I'm like, okay, MI has his moments when he can be dope. But before that, I was like, that guy's whack. So it's okay. And I can tell he meant it as a compliment, so I'm not hating. I appreciate the props.
Well, interesting. But now, well, you know, niggas in Paris.
Yep.
Oh, that song is, you know, the video was insane.
I almost made a version of that.
You almost?
Yep.
Well,
YouTube
you better
version.
Try it out. You better try it out. Get some homeboy in that one. Probably,
going to be called Enygma in Paris.
Now, you think that everything belongs to you, right?
I swear.
You think so?
Mm-hmm.
All right, you wait and see what's up. But anyway, right now, you know this song. I think most of you guys have listened to this song. Everybody listened to this
song. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Is this Busta Rhymes?
Let me tell you how much
Busta Rhymes.
Busta Rhymes killed this.
He killed one. Yeah, I know. He killed it. But now, check this out. A lady who is not into hip-hop, she does Cat Perry. She comes in to do her stuff, her weird. Those girls are always weird to me. I consider them to be weird. Lady Gaga, Cat Perry, they always have, Nicki Minaj. Those are three weird girls.
But those are the ones that are the most boring in chow.
But well, check this out. Cat Perry decides to jump on Niggas in Paris.
Me have jumped. Me, I'm going to take off these headsets and just walk out and protest.
Are you sure? Actually, it is not a full track for now. I don't have a full track. It's a clip that I have. But I want you to listen to Wit Good.
No, I want you to listen to Wit Good.
I got it. You know, my ways. I always find ways to get my stuff. And I managed to get a clip of Niggas in Paris. That was Cat Barry.
This is worse than when Justin Bieber jumped on things and tried to rap.
She was doing a show in Europe.
Uh-huh.
And this is what came through. I don't know. You will tell me what you think about it.
Okay. Punish me. So hot, man, the S wanna find me. First thing you gotta find me. What's cause you getting too mofo lucky? Please remind me. So hot, that is crazy. Y'all don't know, but don't get phase. Be next to go. 82, how to do like this crazy. So hot, that is weird. We ain't even supposed to be here. So hot since we're here. It's all right, we believe fair. Psycho, I'm liable to go Michael. Take your pick, Jackson, Jordan, Game 6. Also, clock. Well, but one thing that she never said was the nigga thing. She kept it. I don't know how she kept it in. And, you know, she came off and she... What do you think about this? Okay, first of all, thank God she wasn't writing her own version. She was basically just spitting Jay-Z's lyrics.
Mm-hmm.
So for that, that shows me that she's a fan of the song. She appreciates it. And it's like, oh, I love this song so much that she memorized Jay-Z's lyrics. The way we all did as we grew up. We were fans
Whoever
it was, whoever Tupac was, we memorized the lyrics. And then we spit them on ourselves. Just that she has a platform and a stage as an artist in her own right,
yeah,
in a different genre, and used that to spit the thing on stage. So I think it's Jay-Z who should be asked about it, how he feels about it. And I'm sure he feels over the moon that he has an artist who appreciates him that much,
yeah,
that she's spitting his verse in front of her fans.
Okay.
Who are interested in a different type of music.
That's nice.
At least that's why I thought it was Justin Bieber style, where Justin Bieber now thinks he wants to be
jumped
an MC.
Jumped on Otis.
Not only Otis, he even jumped on Who Shot Ya by Notorious B.I.G.
Oh, really?
I refuse to listen to both of them.
Okay, well, now check this out. Enygma has some new stuff, and I guess you don't want to miss out on that one. This is a brand new one coming in, and I got nothing to say. Natural Selection introduce the song.
Come on,
we're making history with this one right here. Root. Slicker than a freak sleeve. Bars to jump offense quicker on these MCs. Lyrics that they'll recite and dearest to tell the plight of my constituents. To the listeners, we MPs. See, we illuminate all the valid topics. It's like the radio phone lines or ballot boxes. Discussing sentences are cut above the censorship, but only with the legitimate representatives. Government merited for my special intelligence. This delegate never been delicate, fresher than Deladin. Should've vaccinated what my mama was pregnant with. Came out the womb ill and been killing it ever since. Yeah, that's what they mad at us for. My styles are something I never had a brush off. I'm rapping us all. Got them trusting me to run for office. Here's the thing, I'd rather just walk. Cancel the election.
protection. You are now rocking with the natural selection. Cover me and go in. I bring the horns in. It's like we get this spread.
I'd like to welcome you all to my swearing in ceremony. A verse is a cut.
I bring the horns in. It's like we get this spread.
This is for the people.
Told you, future making history. There you have it. UG Hip Hop First Lady. So presidential.
Natural selection.
Yeah.
Benny Black, Younger, and the man. Interesting stuff. That is a brand new one that is coming in from the main man, that is Enygma, and the other guys on this one. But well, one thing that is always that is, I don't know what it is, but Benny Black.
I'm proud of that boy. He's man. A monster. He's a beast. Guys should not tamper with Benny Black these days. He's a problem.
Too
that,
deadly.
Let
too
me
deadly.
Give you a little history of this track. That beat that you hear. Like the beat?
First of all, this guy, I don't know. At first, the first time I listened to Benny,
yes,
I thought I was like, is this AMI?
Really? You know, you're not the first person to say that. I'm not sure how he'll feel about that. I'll tell him. But I feel he switches up his style frequently enough.
Okay.
Yeah, that if you hear his body of work, you'll hear different. He experiments a lot and tries different things out. Okay. He's a very versatile MC.
Well, tell us about Natural Selection. What makes you come up with Natural Selection? Give it that specific title, Natural Selection.
Now.
And you're going a little political.
Exactly. Now, this track, that beat actually was made by a lady called Ollie Branch.
Okay.
And yeah, we don't have female producers in this town. But she's...
Oh, really?
No, we don't. Do you know any?
No, not really.
I know only two or three. And the other two haven't really put out anything commercial.
But how about Maria?
Which Maria?
From the place next to Hans.
I don't think I know her.
Okay.
Which is a surprise. But anyway, so Ollie was trained by JT at Diego Productions.
Okay.
And this is like only the third beat she ever made. You can imagine, like from day one, as soon as she started making beats, like people were saying, oh my god, that beat is dope. You know, sometimes there's a feminine touch that gives a different perspective. So yeah, she made this beat. It was a fresh sound, interesting idea. Ryonga, I almost said Crooked, which was his former name, but okay. He changed his name. He no longer goes by Crooked. He's now Ryonga.
So Ryonga is Crooked.
Yes. So you know Crooked.
Interesting. Guys have been talking about Crooked, and I know Ryonga. I'm like, who is this guy Crooked? I don't know who it is.
One and the same. One okay. of UG's so best MCs.
Okay, so like Diddy.
So he, as soon as he heard it, he said, dibs. Like, this is mine. It's my beat. I want it. And immediately started writing, and he spat his
that
verse.
That was Ryonga, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Now, he went for that political tone of being like, we are rap representatives of the people, like we're MPs kind of situation, mm-hmm. or presidents, guys who are voted in. To come and spit these beats, that kind of interesting concept, the political yeah. side. So he called me and Benny Black and asked us to jump on this one and also throw a verse in it each. And of course, we're honored to be on a track with someone as legendary in this industry as Ryonga.
Yeah, Ryonga.
And at the same time, Ollie Branch is our friend.
Yeah.
And we're happy to spit on one of her very first beats as well. Mm. Actually, this is the first
beat. That's her first beat
that she's released. Yeah. This is the third beat she ever made.
Okay.
Yeah, so
and the other ones?
The other ones are there. I have one of them.
Okay.
I'll do something.
Natural Selection.
I leave. Yeah, so the track was called Natural Selection, as is on the hook. And we throw a little sly. Actually, the art for this, I really love.
It is really, really dope.
Very, very. They put me there with Obote wearing the Enygma face mask.
Okay.
Ryonga's Museveni and Benny Black is Idi Amin. And I felt the Benny Black was very
sense.
Fitting
it
because his verse,
yeah.
he was
sense.
A real dictator, and his verse, it was pretty mean.
Told you. I just don't know what it is, but well, don't forget. Shovon Malcolm is my name, aka The King. Down with my main man, that is, I wish you'd say that thing, because I don't want to say it.
Yeah,
that is Enygma, the big dog, I should say, in the building. And well, you know how you always do it, just get into our Facebook page, that is Hot 100, leave a space, UG, and tell me what it is. Or better still, you can call up on 0753-109-109. But before we get into something else, you know, there is some trucks that are still, you know, today I want us to cut it down, and get into the vocals. I don't know, like the backbone of that. You know Nipsey Hussle? Jules Otis.
Joel Ortiz.
Yeah, Joel Ortiz.
Yes.
And DJ Hayes. That's something that it did. And now, even my girl, Nicki Minaj.
Is on that same track?
No. Oh. She's not on the same track. She's with Chris Brown. She comes out with that stuff. For the first time, I don't know, like in a long while, Nicki Minaj has done something at least sensible. She spits some buzz.
That was before she joined Young Money.
Yeah, for in a long while. She's been doing some decent stuff. Weird music.
But everything she's been doing lately has been bubblegum pop.
Yeah.
It's not
and
hip-hop.
Now she decides, and maybe she has realized early in the show, I was like, I don't know what's happening to Nicki Minaj now. I think she has realized, oh, she wants to go back to the old self, that she's come up with something new, something different. Where she decides not to come back with buzz and make a statement.
I'll have to hear it to believe it.
Okay, well, we're going to do it like this. We're going to play those tracks back to back. They're both brand new tracks, actually.
Okay.
And I guess nobody... I
can tell. The one with Joel Ortiz, he's going to run over everyone on that track. I don't even need to listen to it. He's going to murder them.
No problem with this one. But, I guess let's just get into it and get to see what's popping. I see the calls busting up already, but I can't be able to take them in right now. Take them in a little bit later on that one. But, well, let's get into this one. This one is a brand new one coming in. And I should say, I'll come up with that one later. That is Coast to Coast, Cassidy, Joel Ortiz, and DJ Hayes. Sir, Icy's in hell today, I'm scared of you. Homie, I'll punch you in your face till your beard is blue. Till your eyes cracked and fatter than what Shakira grew. East Coast shit, squeeze toast quick. Beast, I'm demanding this money, I'm ferocious. You see hoes trick? Nah, we not alike. I get the seesaw treatment from the model type. I love you silky, but head is better. But when I do get the box, I hit the spot with the seventh letter. To make a V with my middle and my pointer. That's a deuce chuck, I gotta run, Jackie Joyner. As far as rap goes, y'all know how that goes. Abner with the flow, I tear you a new boss ass. If you phony, well then never mind me. But if you claiming that you real, you better more fucking recognize. It don't cut out. Well, that is Jules. Oh, I don't know why I call him Jules.
You're thinking of Joel Santana.
No. I don't know why I call it that. But it was Joel Otis, Cassidy, Nipsey Hussle, and that was...
Straight off the bat, I just say Nipsey Hussle's verse should be cut out of that track. He was completely outmatched.
Yeah, I know.
Completely. Cassidy murdered it.
Cassidy and Otis came through in a weird way. But now, check this out. Another one. Brand new one coming in from your girl, Nicki Minaj. I know many people are hating her. But I found some sense. Yeah, I know, for a good reason. But I found some sense in this one. Well, that is a brand new one also coming in from Chris Brown and Nicki Minaj right by my side. And we've been having some interaction, me and Enygma, about the two songs. Well, of course, the other one is way up, but the reason why I considered this song is because Nicki Minaj finally, I don't know whether she's getting some little bit of sense in our head a little bit. Okay, well, not these two Nicki Minaj fans, but she's coming up again. Some sense. She's having some buzz at least. She's spitting up some little buzz that are coming through.
Personally think that this isn't much different from what we've been seeing on her recent Pink Friday album.
Yeah.
That this is pretty much...
Actually, you saw the Pink Friday album, which is coming up on 30 April. The Roman Reloaded album.
Oh, yeah. I was going to say that. The thing is, with Nicki Minaj, when she went to Young Money, she completely dumbed down her style. She lost her cutting edge, her aggressiveness, the wittiness in her lyrics, and she went straight for paint by number style rapping. Now sometimes she goes completely stupid, like in Stupid Hole.
That was crazy stuff.
Nonsense. I can't even call it garbage. That'll be an insult to garbage. But this one, she raps in a competent way, which we know she's capable of doing. This song, in terms of the whole song and even her verse on this, I find comparable to like Moment for Life. Where she doesn't do anything spectacular, but she's not doing really any wackiness either. She's just straight rapping about whatever the topic is at the time and doing it in a competent enough fashion, in an easy to absorb way that is useful for radio friendly jingles like this one. This is a decent R&B type track, which suits the commercial mainstream market very well. And she raps in a way appropriate for that. So it's nothing special, nothing spectacular, nothing different actually from what we've been seeing from Nicki Minaj over the last couple of years.
Yeah, but the reason why I've told you my reason, now turned out to be
This one isn't something that angers you, like the stupid hoe type things that want me to kick your radio in. This one, at least you listen to it, you're like, okay, you know,
fine.
Your blood doesn't boil when you hear her rapping in this one.
Okay, now get into Coast to Coast. Coast to Coast.
I'm annoyed that you cut off Cassidy's verse. Cassidy's verse was dope.
I know it was dope, but I don't know what happened. It just got cut off. I was also surprised.
Is it? I wake up in the morning, I count money until I go back to bed. Like, guys, this is silly. But like, his verse was dope. I think he must have heard like Joel Ortiz go in, and Ortiz murdered it.
Yeah.
So Cassidy said, okay, let me also take myself to that other level. And anyway, Cassidy, everyone knows Cassidy can rap. Yeah, he's a lyricist. He's dope. Nipsey Hussle was completely outmatched.
Out of it. Yeah, it was.
If they wanted to get a West Coast guy to sit in with these two guys, they should have gotten from the West Coast. They would have gotten Kendrick Lamar, The Game, Crooked Eye. But anyway, Crooked Eye, maybe they didn't put him in because of Joel Ortiz. Mm-hmm. Already, they have a member of Slaughterhouse there. But they had other guys they could have picked. Schoolboy Q, you know, other guys. Nipsey Hussle, I wasn't feeling what he was doing.
Interesting stuff. But well, you know where you are right now. That is the Blazing Hot 100, 100.9. That's our dial. And better still, you can always get back to us on our Facebook page, Hot 100 Live Space UG, and tell me what it is. Or better still, get onto our Twitter page, that is Hot 100 UG, and let us know what is getting down. Well, time check, we're ready into the next hour. But well, the next hour coming off with the top 5 Smart Jones of the week. And still we have them, the hip hop show. We have a lot to talk about, that, you know, the hip hop show thing. First part, I might have for the second part.
Second part will be out in a few months.
Okay. Well, that's what it is. Stay tuned, stay listening. I'm going to take in those calls. I'm very sorry for that. When I'm going to take in those calls right up in the next hour, and then you'll be able to talk to the main man, Enygma, in the building. But for now, well, that is Hot Toddy coming in, and it's done by Usher and Jay-Z. And before that, opening up the hour, we had Cello Green, who was coming in with Forget You. Well, we in this hour, we're doing the top 5 Smart Jones of the week. But while we're going on with that still, we have the main man, Enygma, in the building, still going on till the hour of 2 o'clock with me, Siobhan Malcolm, on the Blazing Hot 100. And wherever you might be right now, hope your afternoon is all good, and it's all getting down in a special way on that one. How's your afternoon?
My afternoon is excellent.
Are you sure?
Yep, I'm chilling on the hangover.
And you don't have one, though.
You know.
Well, interesting stuff. More music still coming your way, and we're going to be having our number 5 coming in anytime soon from, you know, I'll let you know. But, 15 minutes past the hour of 1 o'clock. And, we have a lot to talk about. We still have that show.
That show.
And there's one thing I've got to ask you personally.
It's okay.
Off air.
It's okay.
Off air. It is funny though. But right now, it's about time we get into our number 5. And it's coming in from, John Legend and Ludacris. What do you say about this song?
I think Ludacris looks like you.
Looks like me?
Yes.
You're giving people a hint. I hate that. I don't want people to know what I look like.
What you came for? Don't you wish you came more? Girl, what you playing for? Come on, let me kiss that. Ooh, I know you missed that. What's wrong? Let me fix that. Twist that. Baby, hot. Tonight, 100. The night I let you
know.
Baby, tonight, the night we lose control.
Song coming in, Ravita Vampino and JB. Wow, what a great job coming in. Enygma, what do you think about this song, actually?
I think that dope, that track is dope. It's just sick.
You even lost the words.
You know?
Well, interesting stuff. You're still on the Blazing Hot 100. Shovon Malcolm is my name. And you are on the Hangover right now on 100.9. That's the way we're going down. But still, don't forget how to back at your boys. We're in the building. That is Hot 100. Live Space UG. You better still call up on 0792-109-109. Am I saying it again? 0753-109-109-0792-109-109.
I just put it on speed dial. I don't know what the number is.
Well, interesting stuff. Okay, part two. We had a break, 30 minutes, and now we're back, part two. Carmen, I'm just loving this one, though. Uh-huh. And, well, our part two, Enygma, you know, where you've been chilling. What has been happening?
Well, during this 30-minute break,
uh-huh.
You know what? 30 minutes is just about time to do certain things.
Okay, I don't know what to say on that one, but well, more stuff coming in. You have more stuff coming in, and I was surprised when you told me that this stuff now happens to be on the Africa-wide television.
Yes.
That happens to be, I don't know, where is this whole idea coming in? Who brought in the idea? Was you,
JT, McKenzie.
And McKenzie.
Basically, JT was working on a mixtape.
Actually, for your information, if you don't know what we're talking about, it is the hip-hop show.
Yes.
I don't know how to do it. Is it like, should I say this? Kind of cypher? It's not a song, but I don't know how to jam it.
It was an interesting concept. I like playing around with different concepts of making tracks.
Okay.
JT was working on a mixtape towards the end of last year.
Yeah.
And he asked me to feature in it. He played me the beat and said, I'd like you to do something, feature me on the song.
Yeah.
And we started knocking about different concepts. And then we said, why don't we do a concept where we're having a conversation?
Yeah.
Talking about like hip hop, the state of hip hop, maybe as one of the possible topics.
Okay.
And then we said that idea would work best if we had a moderator, if we had like maybe a radio presenter, especially one who's known for having that kind of, maybe those kind of talks.
Yeah.
And he'll be there to manage the conversation between me and JT, offering different sides of the coin.
Okay.
And of course, when we were thinking about it, really the standout name was McKenzie, you know, your former colleague.
Yeah.
Primarily because of all the hip hop playing and presenters that we have in this town, he's the only one who's known to have gone to studio and recorded a few tracks.
Yeah, he's recorded some songs, some good songs. Yeah. That song I forgot to know, the one he did with Lyrical Proof.
He had many with Lyrical Proof.
There is like, one, the famous one.
Smile? No, the smile wasn't with McKenzie.
There is a famous one.
I forget the title. I hope he's not listening. He's going to kill me. But he had retired from recording.
Okay.
But we're like, it's easy to use him because nobody would have to write for him.
Yeah.
You know, if we've got someone else.
Do his own stuff.
Exactly.
Write down his lines and all that.
If we got like another presenter, now you have to start with somebody
for
the very first time. And we felt that considering me and JT are somewhat experienced, we don't want to bring someone who's completely brand new into this art, and then he's learning on the job, especially since this required all of us to write together.
Yeah.
Because we were all having a conversation, so we had to sit in the studio together. Yeah. It was late at night. It was around 1 a.m. or something.
Okay.
Me, McKenzie, and JT were in studio. We discussed that, JT, we're going to start maybe when, like a real radio show, the presenter is going to introduce the artist.
Yeah.
Then he starts off with the first question. Then JT will answer, then I'll interject and I'll answer as well. Then McKenzie goes back and asks another question or follow up to what we've just discussed, that kind of thing. So as we're discussing that in the studio, we're writing our lyrics relating to how the flow of the conversation is supposed to go. And with this particular one, the subject was basically the state of hip hop today and our views on it and how we feel about it.
Yeah.
And then I come in and I complain about the materialism of the direction hip hop has gone. Everyone's talking about bling and fashion and money.
Method Man spoke of that. He was also pissed. Yeah,
I heard Method Man recently talked about exactly the same thing. And so when I mentioned that, like, McKenzie, of course, comes back and starts saying that, you know, this is part of hip hop. We should accept this. And after, so I get really annoyed and I talk about how, no, we should reject this. And of course, JT gives the other side as well, a more sober perspective that, listen, you know, you making money is part of the game. We have to accept this. You know, it's an interesting topic. And
it is a dialogue in a song almost.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And the point isn't to maybe just say that this is 100% the right position or anything. That's why we had different perspectives on the song. But it's just to spark the idea into the listeners' minds.
Yeah.
That are we thinking about these things? Are we considering the direction that hip-hop is taking? Do we want it to go in that direction, or do we want to step in and move it somewhere else?
Yeah.
You know, we just want to encourage that dialogue and that thought process to exist amongst the hip-hop fans and other hip-hop artists.
Okay.
And not only on this topic, many other topics that affect us within hip-hop in Uganda and internationally.
Nice and interesting. Well, probably you've been hearing, you're like, these guys are talking too much. We don't even know what they're talking about and all that. Well, check this out. It is on channel all play.
Yeah.
And well, that's up a notch. Africa-wide, everyone in Africa is watching this, all from Uganda.
And the video was shot in 20 minutes.
I'm proud to be Ugandan. That's what it is. But, well, interesting stuff. Let's get into it. And, of course, you know, let's go into it. This is Hip Hop Show coming in from JT, Mackenzie, and Enygma.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's the hip-hop show. It's Rude Boy hanging out, Big Pippin and Yago. Got my homies JT and Enygma. And you know how we do, it's gonna be a cinema. What's going on, cuz?
I'm more gravy, cousin, I'm cooling off.
Hey, yo, I'm doing good too, Mackenzie. Let's set it off.
Right, let's get it started. What's up with this hip-hop nation? Are we giving the wrong shit our daily rotation?
Hey, yo, I'm bouncing up and down in their minds. Chilling up in their lands. Sitting up in their mansions. Putting buck in their hands. Asking what they can do, stepping up on these grandsies, dictating everything they fancy. Please explain to me the viability of all you pretty niggas' chances. I know what your stance is, I know what you fancy, I know who you dancing with. Classy foolery, hip hop romance.
Well, let me tell you what's annoying me. These rappers purporting to be the masters of all that they see with mansions and jewelry. They wanna act just like the gangsters they see on TV, walking with 100 G's, smacking you like Chisu B. But the truth is that they never sold an ounce of coke, posing in the borrowed cars or rented clothes, cause they are broke. They don't have Mercedes nor a lady in a contour dress. Man, we couldn't save these losers with a control S.
All your horses, cuz. Let's get back to the basics. Hip-hop is a culture. We are born thugs and naughty by nature. We've seen a lot of swag ganging and gang banging. But if I can sing and do him a bling, don't act like I showed ya.
I already showed y'all how to act like a soldier. I put the game on my shoulder, but only some of you sober. I am from a winning team, no fat in my DNA. So this is the only time you hear me say I got some skinny jeans. These days it's about the fashion and the money. These little kids completely lost the plot, just like Shimoni. Materialistic rappers are little illiterate insects, selling out will earn some currency, but not my respect.
Ain't nothing wrong with making money. The job is funny. Either you make dough or make don't. Time is money. If you refuse, you duck it. If you abuse a cousin, it gets ugly. Do it like you choose. Fuck it.
The future, you've been around a couple of years, hanging out, sipping some beers with the illest niggas overseas. Do you see a bright future in the next 5 years?
Well, that's what it is. Do you see a bright future in the next 5 years? That's
yes,
what it
I
says.
Do.
Interesting, man. I like the progress, the
Thank
way it's
you.
Going on for the hip hop world. And of course, indeed, you know, playing on channel, oh man,
yep.
I've seen a couple of things come through.
And it is an unconventional track. You know, it has no hook, for instance.
Yeah, by the way, has no hook.
But nobody notices
that one. Nobody notices it. I've forgotten about that one, and that was pretty so surprising. So. Man, I'm speechless on this one, seriously.
Thank you, thank you. I'm glad it has that impact and that effect on people.
Yeah, sure, and I'm very sure so many people are appreciating that one. Well, you can also be able to get on our Facebook page and let us know about that song specifically, The Hip Hop Show.
Yeah.
And, well, that is part one. I watched the video, and I saw part one. Now, part two.
Now, what JT wants to do is that he wants this to be a running theme.
Okay.
So that in a few months he'll have a part two where the discussion continues. And now maybe another aspect, another question is asked relating to hip hop, and he has different MCs answering.
Okay.
So Big Trill is gonna be in the next one.
Bro!
Yeah, and then there's gonna be Big Trill and two other guys, but they haven't yet been revealed yet. Even I don't know who they're gonna be.
Salute. I have nothing to say on that one, but well, right for now, let's get into our number three joint on the top five smart joints of the week. And it's coming in from a brother and a friend, Navio and Chameleon. What do you have to say?
I love this damn song. It is brilliant, and I'm going to be on the remix, by the way.
I'm tired of those things.
Hey, then, let's go! I had a dream to be a star. Come on.
pen. Here we go again. Alan, you ready? It's history in the making. Let's go! So many stories on my hood, half a tragic. No toys as a kid, to me cash was magic. Outside my window was a wall, that was graphic. Now my view is just so damn panoramic. Way before we were dodging all of the camera flashes. I never prayed much, I just asked for answers. No excuses, I just felt like I had to practice. Rhyming was the disease, I just had to catch it. Battling was my sport, I just had to match it. Number one was my spot, I just had to grab it.
But for now, let's get to our number two, and it's coming in from, that is Esther Dean and Sean Paul. How deep is your love?
Play by the king, call love is all I bring. Baby girl, listen what me sing, yeah. Put a bang, put a bang, 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 bang. Sound up all the more to dance. Yo, girl, just move my hand. I gotta let you know I'm the man. Girl, cause the way you pop wine and a bubble it, make me want trouble it, yeah, me dear. Can't think clear, me just a thing about the way how you're sexy, me want you to bring it, come share up. Tell me a pretty thing, so hard, me girl. I tell you, you're the hottest girl around here. This I swear, me come well, well prepared. Girl, give me the chance, make me shift it in gear. Don't be afraid of me love it, run deep, 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 deep. And that's Mount Everest, this is deep, deep. Ever blessed, ever blazing, girl, so we do it. Program this in your brain and put one repeat, girl. Day after day, so me love is uniqueness. Energy you give me, make me temperature peak, yes. Every time I sight the sexiness and sleekness. Put me warm, put it on my beat, yes. So stop stress, girl. Just let me reveal her. Me redeem the party and make you scream all my name, girl. It's time to get the thing sealed up. Why you feel no summer warp is spin your round, girl. Make you know about the Ferris wheel. You are the magnet, I am the steel. Strong connection, me know you a feel. Don't bother question the thing, don't fight it. Every day with you, night it. Every part of your body get me full flight it. Prepared to give you the bomb, just ignite it. Down the down, feel whatever, something like it. Every time I see you, me get so excited. Every time I dear darker, you come light it. Perfect, to my world, you are the right chick. A summer sight it.
How deep is your love?
Let me show you.
And then that is how deep is your love, Enygma. How deep is your love for her?
Well, your girlfriend told me the answer yesterday.
You're messing around.
I'm joking.
You're messing in the wrong.
Put down that knife, man. Be easy.
You're messing around. That is no go area. Well, everyone, you're still on the Blazing Hot 100. Shavon Malcolm is my name. And we are on the hangover with me and Enygma.
Yep.
And, well, you can be able to join us by calling up on 0753-109-109 or 0792-109-109. This is the time you have before we get a bounce out of the building. Time is just enough on me.
Yeah, already. Time can bounce.
Yeah, like sure did. Bolt. And, well, for now, have messages coming in from different people hollering back and letting us know how it's getting down. This is Habi Carter, who says, for me, that is by Enygma, wax for me. Drop it off for me. Well, I'll try and do something about that quick.
At least it works better than the power.
We have in, yeah, sure. And we have in K, who says, I got news at 2011. After 2 days, are you willing to do news at 2012?
Enygma. Well, it's too early to do news at 2012, but I might do it. I think I might do it at the end of the year. We'll see. Depends how I'm feeling. And if it's an interesting year, if it's an interesting year with a lot of interesting subjects, then okay. Yeah, I think I'll do it.
Well, interesting. And we have more coming in. This is Akisa, who says, I need your face, Enygma.
That won't happen. I'm sorry.
Jackson comes in to say, what's up?
What's up?
Camel says, Three Kings is straight up royal.
Yes, let them know.
Royal.
Royalty.
Arnold says, Enygma, you really know how to judge big shots. Oh, you really know how to judge big shots.
Oh,
you know,
really?
The stuff we're doing out there.
Well, I appreciate that. I'm glad that they appreciate the analysis.
Yeah, and Molly comes in to say, bra, big ups, Enygma, because you inspire me a lot. Fumeme, indeed.
Nice. Thank you,
Mambo. Henry says, I'm an M80. You're a cat dagger.
Yeah, that's the, he's actually pointing out one of my punchlines from Natural Selection. And M80 is some mean machine gun. It is a heavy artillery kind that they almost use on tanks. So I'm making the comparison.
Let me hope Kadaga won't come in because it's a Kadaga.
Yes, that was the point, because it's Natural Selection. We're in politics. I said when you're in parliament,
I know what it is.
Maybe you're a Kadaga.
Yeah. Okay, right, for now, no introduction to this. We're going to come back and talk about this. This is Allow Me coming in from the main man. That is Enygma still.
The Myth, actually.
The Myth, GNL, Big Trill, and JB.
Yeah, and Navio.
Navio on it.
Yeah.
And toast. Clear cut. Clarity. BFB cause and effect. Sandy Rock. Allow Me. Intro. Yeah. I came to ball, and it's no mystery. You're talking all that dough, I take it all, can you almost be? So please allow me to toast to my victory. I mean, I win each time you go and mention me. They say I'm arrogant, but really I'm just hoping my money joins the Fab Clan and goes Arabic. You can't handle me, cause I drop dope joints after dope joints. You're just dropping your cannabis.
Hey, yo, Enygma has joined the fray. Don't need to swim in AC to be cool with all these fans. I'm blown away. Evidently, nobody messing with me. Got an excellent track record, recording tracks excellently. So don't catch feelings when you find out that your ex is with me. Just allow me to have a ball testically. And do not throw me up a verse, boy, I don't need that. Cause I'll vomit all over you, nigga. Now that's how I get feedback.
Allow, really, allow me. Allow, allow me. Please allow me to stunt on y'all niggas, please. Allow me to front on y'all women, please. Hey, really, allow me.
Allow.
Hey, sister, allow me.
Allow.
Please allow me to stunt on y'all niggas, please. Allow me to front on y'all women, please.
Blistering barnacles. Bleeding testicles, I'm fasting rappers' balls like groupie knives and booty calls. It's a hip-hop song, allow me say fucking it. Standing ovation, please applaud me. If it's a Game of Thrones, they crown me. It's a bloody chow, please allow me. Or I get it ugly like Straka in a bikini. I'm a motherfucking bad ass. Mussolini.
I've seen my pussy Dan Jarrett. A lot of people can say my name but can't spell it. Really?
Hot.
If you got beef, just bugger it up and eat it. We ain't friend with your ass. I swear to God with the spit of end. And this shit is wag. My bars are made out of iron. And yours, nigga, they kind of more like Kit Kat. And your niggas timid. I be moving so fast while your motherfuckers slow like marijuana minutes.
Oh. Allow,
really,
allow me. Allow, allow me. Please allow me to stunt on y'all niggas, please. Allow me to front on y'all women, please. Hey, really, allow me.
Allow.
Hey, sister, allow me.
Allow.
Please allow me to stunt on y'all niggas, please. Allow me to front on y'all women, please.
me. These rappers know I knock lights out. Remember, my product get you higher than AUG and Tebe. Yep. Flow spread germs when I spit in sanitary. Limits like those kids on the shit. No dairy. I hear them talking, but these niggas ain't saying shit. It's a pull on Heidi Hammer, we never making hits. So please allow me to move the game with an R. Yeah. Cause your niggas like Mr. DJ, always walking, never running shit.
Allow me. To drill you women like I was Saudi, and then I'm Audi. To holler at your daughter with no dowry. Allow me to allow you to crown me. It's a wonder that my flow hasn't drowned me. Even the Cirque du Soleil couldn't clown me. Pound me, but shillings are do fine. Fuck a watch, I'll be killing that hater in due time.
Allow, really, allow me. Allow, allow me, please allow me to stun on y'all niggas, please. Allow me to front on y'all women, please. Hey, really, allow me.
Welcome and allow me.
Yeah.
The Myth, Enygma, GNL, Big Trill, Navio,
and JB. All-star cast.
Well, just, that's what it is.
This was just guys being drunk and disorderly in studio like at 4 a.m. in the morning. And then cause and effect, a beat appears. A cause and effect again, who also did the beat of Three Kings.
Okay.
And all of a sudden, guys are like, let's just jump on this and kill it.
Who was the first to see it? Who had the Lulu? Myth. Who had
the
Lulu?
The Myth started, mm-hmm. Of course. And of course, Baboon Forest was around minus Moonji. I think Moonji was in other things that night. Okay. So GNL and Big Trill threw their things on after that. Then me and JB walked in and they played us what these guys
were doing. You were like, chi-chi-chi-chi-chi-chi. What's going on?
Actually, what we were told, Myth just said, yeah, play for Enygma and JB this track. So Lamara plays it because it was recorded at Talent Africa. So he plays it. As we're listening, you know, GNL and Big Chill all there, we're all listening to things. So, dope. Then the Myth looks at me and JB says, yeah, write your 8 bars. You're great.
I can imagine the Myth turning around is like,
okay. He says, yeah, both of you, I need 8 bars from you each. You're going in. Then he got on the phone and he called Navio. I was like, yeah, I almost said his real name. I'm not supposed to mention government names here. So he's like, Navio, yeah. write 8 bars. We're going to do a track called Allow Me with Baboon Forest and these guys. Yeah. So, yeah, that's how we did it. It was just everyone jumping in, just having fun. Just, again, showing off. Just
talent. You're just making some people think they got the you, or they have no talent or something like that.
Well, it was fun. We have, and some of us have similar fan bases, others have different fan bases, and it all come together. And
most of you on the song have actually the same, almost the same.
I'd say half of us do. Yeah. But like a Baboon Forest and Clear Cut fan base doesn't always cross over. And it was basically just to show unity in the game, that we're all of us are big artists in our own rights. We all have our different styles, and we have different approaches to the way we make hip hop, and sometimes that causes division in the industry. But we're standing together saying, listen, we have our differences in approach and in our style and in our art, but at the end of the day, we are one, we are together.
Look at us. Beefing.
No beefing. We're sitting together on the track and having fun. We're just a strength of unity, just like the way we did with Competition Is Dead last year.
Deadly.
This is just basically a smaller version.
And I don't know how you missed out on another Hands production.
I also don't know how I missed out on that one, actually.
You missed out. You should have.
But at the same time, that one was more, I feel, of a dancehall reggae type of track. Which, because the MCs on it were like, well, there was Atlas, Big Trill, and Moonji. Navio wasn't on it.
Navio was on.
No.
I'm getting it wrong.
No, you're thinking of UG Swag.
Oh, yeah.
You're thinking of UG Swag. Now, UG Swag, I missed being on that by one day. Basically, Swang's Avenue.
Swang's Avenue, yeah.
Their studio is actually walking distance from my house.
Okay.
And so I just walked in one day. Yo, what's up? Just Jose, you guys, what's new? They play for me UG Swag.
When it's complete.
And I'm like, what the hell? I'm like, when did you guys do this? They said yesterday. And I was like,
And you got out of the boy. Like, you got to a boy.
I'm just down the road from that. I'm your neighbor. And I'm like, is there room? Can I squeeze in somewhere? I said, sorry, man. Oh, we only needed 9 spots and they're full.
Hey, caller, what's up? What's up? You laughing the blazing hot.
Hello, Mr. Maluko.
Hey, what up? How you doing? Where you calling from? And what's your name?
This is Hakim calling from Chebando.
Oh, Hakim from Chebando. Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum salam wa rahmatullah.
Talk to Enygma.
Enygma, Mr. Umeme.
Yes, how are you doing? I'm not Mr. Umeme.
Mr. Umeme, are you the owner of Umeme?
I, unfortunately, I'm not. If I was, you would have power.
Okay, just I'm saying that because I appreciated the what you did to Umeme, hitting at Umeme.
Thank you, thank you. You know, I was I had enough.
Fake.
Yes, they are.
Even right now, we don't have power where we are.
Aye, that is unfortunate. You're listening from your phone.
We are just now using the local battery.
I am using the local batteries.
And those ones are going to wind down as well.
Okay.
But we always look toward 100.
That's what it is. Business. That's what's up.
Yeah, thanks for the music.
Okay, I appreciate the support, man. Thank you, Hakim.
Did you expect something new?
Well,
we've been playing new stuff.
Yes, we played 4 new tracks today.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah, and of course, as always, there's more stuff. Always, we're always in studio. Actually, even I think from here, I'm going straight to studio to record new stuff.
Yeah, big up to yourself.
Okay, thank man, Hakim, thanks for calling through. More calls 0792109109. Simple, just that. Probably one last call, and we call it a day on the show. Wow, what a day's been. Interesting stuff only. And we're having more messages coming in here. This is Kema, who says, slicker than a fringe wave.
I think he was trying to quote Rionga on his verse on natural selection. And actually, he has kind of misinterpreted the line. It's French leave rather than French weave.
Okay.
No, French leave is when somebody is.
You're live on the blazing.
Hello?
Yo, mate, how you doing?
I'm good, how are you?
I'm very great. Who are we talking to?
You're talking to Joseph.
Joseph, where are you calling from?
Joseph
Matiko, Muyenga.
Muyenga. Aye, aye, aye. Representing okay. Muyenga, stand up.
Yeah, that's what's up.
Well, talk to Enygma. Talk to Enygma.
Anyway, I was just going to tell what's up. I just like your show anyway. I don't know. I'm just lucky that I'm online right now.
Oh, you online?
Yeah, I'm calling because I always call and I don't go through, so I'm just calling.
Thank you very much, homeboy. Thanks for listening in always, mate.
Okay.
Tell your brothers, your uncle, auntie, granny, and everybody to tune in every day.
Alright.
And keep ripping up. Mienga.
Okay, cool.
Okay, mate. Thanks for calling through. One last call, 0753-109-109 or 0792-109-109. Emma Rap G has seen your message. He's saying, thanks for the show, mate.
Uh-huh.
Well,
yeah, Marab G is one of those guys who's very active on Facebook.
Yeah, it's a pleasure. I know Beatu Santos. Let me hope I got the name right. That is one big fan of Hot 100, of music, of hip-hop. And to me, too, man, is always a great guy.
We need more people like that to always represent Ugandan music.
Big ups to you, mate.
In particular, Ugandan hip-hop.
Connor, what's up?
Hello, what up?
I'm great. Who are we talking to?
Brian,
where'd you come from?
Hello?
Yo, Brian, where are you calling from? Hello, Brian.
Ha, Umeme has cut off his phone.
Okay, sorry about that. Well, I guess that's just about it for the calls today. My man Enygma, I appreciate you coming around.
Anytime.
I had fun from 12 till now.
Time just disappears. It's like 30 minutes and 2 hours.
Well, crazy stuff going down. Maybe next time we'll have some other time and you come, friend. We do something on that one. Yeah, sure.
As I get new stuff, I'll be bringing it here, definitely. Always enjoy being on your show.
I want you to do me something.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Something.
What do you mean?
You know what I mean.
Ah, damn you. You want me to spit?
Do me something. Of course, you know, you never come on my show and you don't do something. You never come on my show and you don't do anything. No, no way. That's a culture and it always has to be taken up.
Let me see.
And you're not going to do it with any beat. You're just going to flow it and make it nice.
You want me to just go a cappella?
Yeah, a cappella. That's it.
Okay. Let me see. No one expecting me to wreck it in seconds. Break you like Tekken, never with weapons. Did I mention I wreck in the seconds? All I need to break a record for making records. So reckless, don't need a necklace to shine. Can eat you punks for breakfast like serial killers. Ah, that's just me having a little fun without a beat.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, no, keep it locked to Hot 100.
Should I give you that bit?
Which one?
Of, no, but you don't like that guy, so I don't know. My bet I've been using.
Let me think of something, let me think of something to wind out the show, like, keep it locked to Hot 100, don't you dare change over, or I'll run you over your face in a Range Rover, give you a makeover, we're here to take over with Shovon, I never drink, but I got lots of bars here on the hangover.
Whoa! That's it, we're signing out, and it's all great stuff happening, but whoa, you told me this song, you know the song, right?
Which one?
Before we bounce.
I was a little boy. Beautiful with many voice. Dreams in my head.
Yeah.
I needed no money.
You know I'm on a remix, right?
Tub in my hands. I wanted to move the world, yeah. I wanted to inspire the world, yeah. I wanted to be Superman.
Hey, what's up? This is Maurice Kiria, and you're listening to The Hangover with Shovon Malcolm.
Well, thanks for listening to the Hangover Podcast with Shovon Malcolm. To get me, get on Twitter, that is @ Shovon Malcolm, or Facebook, King Shovon Malcolm. Well, be well and take care.